Love our last guys here back an episode of Ultimate Animal Dreadnoughts Shipyard Champions. I got fifth place last week. Even though I was very speedy, I didn't really think about the time. I was just like, oh yeah, speed. Speed's the important metric here. And I'm like, no, it was time. So after the battleship trials, we now have the, or, well, wow, I flubbed that up. The cruiser trials, we have the battleship trials. And there is some design choices that you can do. So it's going to be the exact same battle metrics except for one thing. We'll have the United States versus China. Fifteen enemy battleships. Always 20,000 meters. That is the requirement. Just checking if I'm missing anything else. Now the thing is, there is a metric to making the slightest one possible. It's 25,000 ton dreadnought. Will give me a bunch of time, because it's like how Formula One is with time trials. So I'm getting a lot off of my time by doing this. The Giga Tower. My ship costs $2.5 billion. Alright, last final check. I have all the right things together. 1940s, one battleship, 15 enemy battleships, 1940s me, 1900s them. I will get a lot of points off because I am making, or a lot of time off on my score, because that is what's counting towards the battleship trials. And I just now need to focus on getting as much damage done as fast as possible. But also not getting sunk by the enemy battleships in the progress. Well, I think I got like 20 minutes, about 20 minutes in game time. We'll go over that. But my ship is 25,000 tons. Do quick maths. It is about 3 minutes and something. In terms of time. Which might actually change my position on the scoreboard. The problem is, it's really up how other people do. Because other people beat the other challenge in 4 minutes. So they could literally do that again. Really depending on how they maneuver. Anyway, that's it for this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like, comment, subscribe. Also, go check out the other contestants in the links below. Why?